Hello boys and girls, welcome to peek over my shoulder in Wasteland 2. We have reached the Citadel after a long while. Like, we haven't been here for seriously long time. No, don't, save. Right, first off, let's check our gear. What's happening? Who are they? Huh. Okay. I knew it. Schultz. What? Yeah, okay. So, Pepper Schultz. Wait. Hello. Whew. Okay, so what's happening here? Now that we have reached the Citadel in mostly one piece, I think we might want to leave the rat here, and I think we might even want to leave him here. I'm not sure yet. Where's Bargus? And more importantly, can we go in now? Oh, okay. Awesome.
Whoa.
Angelic wire insert here. Somehow I was under the impression that we had to actually install the repeaters before we were granted access. Well, this changes a lot. Oh, I'm not gonna trade right now because I want to drop off some of the doodads. There's the well, there's Angela. Yeah, let's go into the city.
Ooh, shiny.
Man, this beats Master Kekabus' place all the heck.
Ooh. We're pretty special too, you know? Like in trouble or damn, I bet this is another Easter egg, isn't it? Except this time I'm missing the reference. Carry on, move along. This looks like a library. Can we talk to them? Ah, Vargas is here. survey report. I wanna check the premise. Hello. Oh. Oh. Damn, and I've sold them all. Of course, I can just buy them back, I guess. Okay. Oh, okay, let's deal with equipment too. Hey, we have lost it out there for a while already. Barter skill bonus. We could probably use some armor for some of our buggers. What can we sell? You know what? I'm gonna deal with this later. Yep. Ah, no. I don't wanna right now, not now. Go away. Bye.
So, can I get guns here and stuff?
Yes, Rafi, you can get guns here and stuff. Does this mean you can use materials as well? Where's the storage?
That should work. Yes, that's better.
Okay, so that door leads to her office. What about this? What's this? Ah, okay. Ah, this is the mess hall. Okay. Hello. We should hide our rat. And I know a mic hunt.
Smells delicious.
Okay, what else is here? Barrels. We should break them because reasons. This is something doodaddy. This looks like a thing. Hello? Why does he have the postal uniform? No, wait, I wanted to talk to him. Where did you go? No. Okay, he didn't have any speech options. Never mind then. Whoa. Air traffic control, huh? Okay, let's not break in anywhere just yet. Not until we have gotten to know the place better and met the locals and whatnot. And at some point we should probably go and report as well. Yeah, speaking of scorpions, I think when we go check out the prison again, then we need the full crew of 6. Bang, 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 bang. Okie dokie. Ooh. Okay, this fun explosion, we like it. We're totally gonna gear up on some of these before we go to the prison. Now, I didn't mean to open the trade inventory again. Do that in Wasteland 1, I mean. Let me guess. You would be buying some raw materials too. Ooh, I have bad shit. Gotcha. I knew it was a good reason to carry this along all this time. Shouldn't this count like a quest item or something? Yeehaw. Oh, it does. Okay, these are all trading items, so I guess we need to leave you alone right now.
Like a goddamn candy store in here. Gimme.
Shush. We aren't supposed to get there yet. I like how the explosives guy is placed like farthest away from everybody else and in extra padding and extra concrete. We have already met him. Oh, okay. Oh. Well, first let's start small. Sure. I'm gonna hold on to Ace's star. Maybe Angela wants it too. Whoa. Whoa. Okay, yes, I'm holding on to Ace Star for a while. Manual save. Ooh. You know what? I'm gonna sneak in a very quick
Echo One, your recent progress merits a field promotion for one of your team. Congratulations, Echo One. You've done well.
Thank you. Show them levels. So first off, stuff that I already have. Yeah, perception. No question about that. I'm gonna hold on to these points, I think. Oh yeah. So this might work. Ralph get a perk? Nope, not yet. And he doesn't get any either. Okay, let's carry on. the fresher, of course. Gilbert. I think I've got some new places for you. Okay, so this map does indeed extend a little bit over the, like, the bones of this map don't exactly match with the bones of Wasteland 1 map. Gee, thanks. Yeah, there's the thing. Plants won't grow without water, so if we let the water supply be destroyed, there wouldn't be any plants too. Now, would it? Trouble.
Gee, I didn't know there were this many books in the whole world. Do you have any books with pictures?
Ooh. Okay, so one part at least was in Vargas's office. I guess there will be more. Elsewhere. Ooh, doctor! A real doctor! Just checking if you have stuff we can nick. Yo! Hello! What's this? Oh. Oh my. Okay, later. Right now I want to talk to you. He's obviously in some sort of trouble. Really? Actually, with his skills, he heals upon revival anyway. Okay, let's take notice and move on. Oh, this must be the museum. Heyo, is that you? And I think this also counts as a statue. Woohoo! Really? You're gonna tempt me with a button game? Yeah, I think this is Ralph's skill. Probably get some reference out of it, but I don't. Yeehaw! I hate quick reaction games. No. Damn it. Whoops. Whoops. Okay. I guess if you do very well with this, you might gain something. Oh. Quick save first, just to be on the safe side. Trying. Try again. You can do this. You're expecting a bloody miracle. What's this? Oh, this is the supercomputer. What did we just see? Show me. Oh, it's for toaster repair. Well, Rafi, all yours. Hello. Okay, and Okay. Okay, so that's where this one was. What about the arcade machine? Ah, okay, I missed the credit card case before. Ookie dookie. Show it to me again. Blue, orange and white. That's a Visa combination, isn't it? So now you appreciate our choice, do you?
Wow.
Also, let's check out this whole BB gun situation. Oh, pipe bomb. Is going to him. I'm gonna give it to Randy. Oh, okay. Anna is the former prostitute that they married them as. Okay, got it. Whoops. Didn't mean to drop them. Show me. What happened to the BB ammo? See it dropped, and I don't see anybody else carrying it. What happened to it? Doesn't have it. He doesn't have it. She doesn't have it. She doesn't have it, probably. Keep forgetting that reloading a weapon in inventory probably doesn't work the way. Probably doesn't work like it did in original Fallout. Can we go down here? Not from here. Okay. Remarkable. So where is this storage that we keep hearing about? This one? Okay. Let's put these in here for safekeeping. Because every now and again I accidentally use them up, so there's that. Give this to Ralph instead. I'm gonna keep this one and put these away. Engineer's note, what's this? No, no, don't put it in there. Gets one phone. Well, better balanced now, I think. Somewhat, maybe. What is he carrying? And he doesn't have any ammo. That's important. So if Rafi is using BB gun, and I've lost the ammo now, which is problematic, so I'm gonna keep these on him anyway. Give these to him instead, and grant him some ammo. Goody. Oh yeah, let's put these in here as well. Huh. And where did we even get it? Oh my, the thing is sewers. Okay, I'm gonna get back to this later. Intelligent report. Farmer's diary, farmer's diary, farmer's diary. Oh, and we don't need to carry the story of John Henry around anymore, do we? Whose is this? Ooh. Interesting. Hehehehe. Oh, of course. Geography doesn't match up. This is more Fallout territory than Wasteland territory. So wait, if this is part 3... He started in part 1, part 2, part 6, 5... 1, 2, 3... We're missing part 4. Farmer's Diary, John Henry... Okay, so this is the quote-unquote storyteller, and the other Wait, did the other text just go away after I read it? Page 2. This is going to take some longer time. Oh, okay, so the blue pages are the quote-unquote official story, and the one with the pencil is Vargas' story. Got it. Right, we've been loitering around for quite long now.
You cops got all the latest technology. No wonder crime don't pay.
Let's get in here now. And also save. Okay, so part 1 and 2 are here. Take it. Let's talk to you guys first. So he's the one who was on the radio.
Welcome, recruits.
First.
Nice to finally make your acquaintance. Good work saving the day and attaching the repeater units in Highpool. The General and I thank you. Now I'm guessing you're here to learn more about these mysterious broadcasts that you've been helping us with.
Sure.
We don't know where they're coming from or who's making them. Hell, they could be old pre-war recordings for all we know. But we've been hearing them since the skies started to clear. And they've got a threatening sound to them, so we've been trying to learn more about them. Which is what we sent Ace out to do when that robot murdered him. Now, you've already attached one of our repeater units to the radio tower at Highpool. But because you were unable to do the same at Ag Center, we're in a bit of a bind. See, we intended to make a Watson-Watt Adcock antenna array using those two towers. Our tower here, and the tower where Ace died. Linking those four would have allowed us to pinpoint the origin of the signal. Now, however, we're going to have to try to find the radio tower the General already mentioned to you in DeMonta, if it even exists.
Okay. Now, I accidentally clicked somewhere, so he kept talking, and now I lost track. Yeah, skies.
Well, it's only a theory, but my guess is that the fallout that's been floating around up there in the ionosphere since the war has been muddying things up there. Stopping long-range broadcasts from being reflected back to Earth. Now, maybe the fallout is starting to decay, and the ionosphere is slowly returning to normal, allowing it to reflect radio waves like it used to back in the good old days. Or not. I only know what I read in salvage books.
Okay.
You sure you want to hear this? Most people's eyes glaze over when I start getting technical.
You can get technical on
really?
Me.
Okay, you asked for it. So with the traditional Watson-Watt method of radio direction finding techniques, it is possible to find the direction from which a radio signal was transmitted using two Adcock antenna pairs to perform an amplitude comparison on the incoming signal.
Oh, okay.
An Adcock antenna pair is a pair of antennas that take the vector difference of the received signal at each antenna so that there is only one output from the pair of antennas. Two of these pairs generate what can be referred to as north-south and east-west signals, which will then be passed to the receiver. In the receiver, the bearing angle can be computed by taking the arctangent of the radio of the north-south to east-west signal. Given any four antennas of a known distance from each other, this method can establish a very accurate directional vector on an incoming signal.
Makes sense.
Satisfied? We use the repeater units to boost a weak radio signal out in the field and transmit the data back to the Citadel. And let me tell you, it was hell trying to find enough parts to make the ones we needed, which is why I'm so glad you were able to find the ones Ace was carrying. I'm so glad you were able to save Highpool. Its reservoir and treatment plant provides water for us and the other communities in the area.
And let's get some back too.
I'm very sorry you weren't able to save Ag Center. They were doing so much to develop hardier animal and plant stock that would survive out here in the wastes. It's a real blow to have lost them. I've been hearing the Red Scorpion's radio chatter about this place for more than a year now. They claim it's somewhere beyond the eastern radiation clouds. I hope they're right. The radio tower that Gilbert says is rumored to be there could be our only hope for tracking down those mysterious broadcasts. Well, I'm not gonna say anything bad about the general when I'm sitting right next to him.
You better not, Woodson. I'll take away your smokes ration.
See? But seriously, I think the general has been a wise and cautious leader these past 15 years. Some of the boys may think he keeps it a little too cautious, but they're not the ones who have to feel the calls when good men die. Since we started hearing these strange broadcasts, he decided that the quiet times are over, and his place is here, on the air, listening to the people of the wastes and sending his troops into battle. Well, we spent the 15 years since we defeated the base code chief's AI retrenching, rebuilding the Citadel, rebuilding our numbers, solidifying our position. It made us a stronger organization, I think. But we also have a smaller footprint now, and some of the places we used to patrol have kind of fallen off the map. Now, though, I think it's time to wake up. The world is changing. These crazy broadcasts, the Red Scorpions in the old prison, reports of trade routes to the east, where we thought there was nothing but radiation. If the Rangers still want to be a force for good in the world, then we gotta start stepping out beyond our own backyard.
Yeah, tell me about the prison.
Our old home base. Not bad for what it was, but we've been outgrowing it for decades. When we cleared the previous owners out of this place, we saw an opportunity to make a move. We always thought the radiation east of the prison was just too strong, and that travel that way was impossible. But now the Scorpions are claiming they've established trade with a community beyond the radiation called Damanta, and also with a group calling themselves the Servants of Titan. We're not welcome in Scorpion territory, so we can't check the truth of all of this. But they do seem to be getting better weaponry from somewhere, so maybe it's legit. The Red Scorpion Militia. They took over the old prison when we moved out. Not really much more than a raider gang, but they're starting to tell everybody that they're the real law in Arizona. And they're asking people to call them for help instead of us. Maybe they're really trying to shape up, but I doubt it. Sounds more like an old-fashioned shakedown scheme to me.
Some of these dialogues seem to be meant for a time when you haven't really been to the prison yet. So I wonder if we could have actually got the next Citadel earlier. Because it seems that getting the repeater up in Highpool really was the thing that gained us entry. Okay, carry on.
It was the Rangers' greatest enemy. Though really all it was a malfunctioning machine. The mainframe of a pre-war military facility that somehow got it into its circuit board head that everybody in the world was its enemy. It started pumping out robots to defend itself. And if we hadn't stopped it, those robots could have killed everyone in Arizona. All right.
Okay, okay.
Good luck out there. You'll be hearing from us. A tough choice, recruits, with no good outcomes. Still, you chose well. Keeping Haipu friendly is crucial to our plans for Arizona.
We can't talk to him or her. So they are just bodyguards, I take it? Okay,
then.
Damn fine work, recruits. Rail Nomad is whole again at last. Now we're gonna see some progress. I hear you've been patrolling near our old HQ. Well, keep a low profile. We have enough on our plate right now without a turf war to contend with.
So So yeah, everybody is reacting to everything that we have done in the meantime, which kind of reinforces the idea that we probably could have gotten access earlier. Okay, let's talk to the man.
So you saved Highpool at the expense of Ag Center. A tough decision, and I know it must weigh heavily on your minds. But a choice had to be made, and once you chose Highpool, you did all you could to save it and its people. I'm particularly pleased that you helped Kate Preston become the new mayor over there. She's the kind of pragmatic, level-headed leader the old place needs. Also, let me personally thank you for finding Ace's killer, whatever it was. I'm sorry your initiation into the Rangers has been such a trial by fire, but you've proven yourself tough under pressure, and in my eyes, that makes you fit to be a Ranger. Welcome aboard. Now, any questions?
Yes, all the questions. Where do we start?
It is your home now, recruits. A place to rest and resupply between missions. A place to learn and to share your knowledge with others. But it's more than that. Despite its tarnished history, the Citadel is a force for good, a shining beacon of justice in a dark land, a bulwark against barbarism in a world of lawlessness and brutality. Indeed, it is the furrowed field out of which the seeds of order will grow into a new and better civilization. Hey, forgive me. Get carried away sometimes, but I do believe we are making a difference despite my shortcomings, and that our flame must not be allowed to be snuffed out. That's why we need young, motivated recruits like yourselves.
Well?
I've been too cautious, recruits. Since we took this place over 15 years ago, I focused too much on keeping the peace in areas we know, and not enough on outside threats. I wanted to rebuild, get our numbers up, but all I've really been doing is letting the world pass us by. Well, that's gotta change, and the change starts with you. You are going to find out where this threat is coming from.
Right.
You want to talk to our quartermaster, Sergeant Melson, about that. He'll provide you with all the weapons, armor, and gear you need to carry out your duties in the Wastelands. You may also want to talk to Ethel Mercaptain, or TNT-10, if you need something special.
Oh, we didn't talk to her, did we?
Our munitions expert. Crazy bastard is going to blow us all up one day. Does good work, though. In the field, his ordnance is highly reliable. It's just his workshop that scares the bejesus out of me.
Hence the sandbags.
One of the brightest minds in the Citadel. She's really helped us get our weapons and armor up to scratch, and she's always coming up with new and better stuff. Worth a visit just to see what she's got cooking.
Okay.
You are our next generation recruits, and I want you to make us proud. Remember that every action you take reflects directly upon the Desert Rangers as a whole. We've worked hard to gain the trust of the people of Arizona and to have them accept our authority. Keep that in mind every time you draw your weapon or make a promise. The lives of other Rangers and the rule of law depend on your wisdom, honor, and forbearance.
Okie dokie. Well, let's ask about people in the Citadel first.
Nelson's all right. A bit young, a bit rowdy, a bit gung-ho. But the Rangers need that now. We need new blood, like yourselves. Woodson's that man right over there, my radio wingman. The man who keeps me on the air. If you want to know more about the repeater units or how to use your radio, see him. Flintlock was old when I was your age. Now he's ancient. Knows more about the history of the Desert Rangers than any man alive. And he'll tell you so himself.
Gotcha. Okay, now where do we start? Let's start from the end.
We have a library here, where we can compile maps and information about the region to help us with our work. If you want to know about any old tech or ancient knowledge, go talk to old Flintlock there. If you've got map questions, see Gilbert. He's our cartographer. Gilbert was another one of my squad. We called him Frasher back in the day. A good man to have in a tight spot. Past his fighting days now, though. Took a wound during the Battle of Base Cochise and never fully recovered. Now, he's our cartographer and damn good at it. You'll find him in the museum with Flintlock.
Okie dokie.
I don't know. Ace fought plenty of robots in his time, and they never gave him any trouble. So I'm wondering if this was something new, something worse. And if it is, we better find out. Listen, if you brought that thing back with you, or even just a part of it, show it to Mer-Captain over in the armory, like I said. She might be able to ID it.
Where did we put it, exactly? I mean, we... Did we drop it somewhere?
And here, take this with you when you bring something to Mer-Captain. It's a requisition form for some of Mer-Captain's top-shelf gear. Finding Ace's killer, you deserve it.
Okay. Yeah, now I have to think. We might have dropped off some stuff outside. That might be it. Because I don't think we're carrying the robot leg with us anymore.
Let me see that. Should be some initials scratched into the back. Damn. HR. Hellraiser. I was afraid of this. Hadn't heard from him in weeks. He'd been chasing those radio signals, too. Anything else on the body? His logbook? Let me have a look. Yeah, this is Razor's all right. Let's see what he was up to. Metal book. Plague. Darwin. I hope that doesn't mean what I think it means. Could be. Or another one like it. Looks like it might have killed Hellraiser, too. Well, combined with the word Darwin, it's making me think this damned monk was looking to recover some of Finster's old research from Darwin Village. Finster was working on all sorts of bioweapons. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if he brewed up some sort of plague. And if this metal monk is after it, we've got trouble.
Trouble.
I know you've got a lot of other things on your plate, but this could be important. I'm marking Darwin on your map, and I'd appreciate it if you'd swung up that way and had a look around. It looks like someone's already marked it on your map. I can usually tell Sergeant Segarra's writing by how neat it is. Angela's is about as orderly as you'd expect. Yep, Darwin Village. Used to be a research facility run by a crazed android named Finster. Went nuts and started making monsters instead of trying to save the world. Or whatever it was he was meant to be doing. The Rangers killed him and pretty much wiped Darwin off the map about 15 years ago. But we might have missed something.
Okay.
Well done, Rangers. Let me see it. This last bit is interesting. All these names and places. I heard a few of them when Woodson played me the transmissions. At least I think that's what I heard. The static was terrible. Anyway, I'm afraid the names don't mean much to me, but some of the places sound familiar. I just can't... Listen, check with Gilbert Segarra, our cartographer. He may recognize him and be able to use him to figure out where the transmissions are coming from.
Okay. And last matter.
Ace and I went way back to the prison days. We fought Finster and the base Cochise robot army together. We rebuilt the Citadel from scratch. That I sent him on the mission which got him killed hangs heavy on my heart, and Angie's never gonna forgive me. Our old stomping grounds, since right after the apocalypse. We moved out of there about 15 years ago when we took over this place. It wasn't a bad place, but the Citadel is more defensible. The Red Scorpions have moved into the prison since then. Nasty bunch from all accounts. They call themselves the Red Scorpion Militia now, And lately, they've been filling the airwaves with a lot of trash about how they're the real law and order around here. Just another raider gang, if you ask me. I don't give them the time of day. Craziest jackalope we ever faced. Might have been human once. Might have been sane, too. But when we met him, he was a crazy android bent on wiping out the human race and replacing us all with mutants. Got his head in our museum if you want to take a look. Place was nearly the death of us. Hell, it was nearly the death of the whole human race. Damned malevolent mainframe churning out an endless army of robots. If we hadn't stopped it, well, I hate to think. Another of the old gang back from the day. She's a tough cookie, Angie, but she's pretty broken up about Ace. They were close. Make us proud, recruits.
So, this is the general's office? Man, he must be the most important person in the world.
That's your next generation for you. Okay, so we have met most of the staff in the Citadel now. We have reported to Vargas. We still have some stuff to pick up and report, but since most of all this is done, I am going to end this probably very long episode here. Carry on soon. So, bye bye for now. See you then. And thank you for watching.